Okay. Let's start the administrative appeal portion of the meeting. Gentlemen, since this is going to be quasi-judicial, I would like to ask that we appoint due to the judicial nature of these hearings, I would like to ask that we appoint Rich Neville as our hearing officer. The decisions are still ours, but Rich will basically run the meeting. Do I hear a motion?
So moved.
Got a motion. How about a second?
Second.
Got a second. All those in favor? Okay. We have also had a request by the county to change the order of the appeals to hearing 03 first, 07 second, 04 third, and 05 fourth. Is there an objection from Mommies Properties, or do you care? Dead last.
Okay. Yeah, I'm sure. Hi, I'm Vinay from Mommies Properties. I have a question.
Question is, the county has asked that we reorder the appeals to be hearing 03 first, 07 second, 04 third, 05 fourth, and 06 last. Is there an objection?
Could I ask why?
Sure. I think we tried to discuss this, but the idea is 7 and 3 both deal with engineering department issues, so we kind of hope to put the two of them together, and then 4 and 5 dealt more with the planning department issues, put them together. That was
okay, yes.
All right. Then we
no objection.
Thank you. We will reorder them. Rich, you want to explain the rules?
Chairman, you
want
to go ahead and
I need to open
the public hearing.
All right, I want to open the public hearing for AP180003. Can I have a second?
Second.
Got a second. All those in favor?
I thought we were doing 7 first.
No. No, we changed it. It's 03 and 07. All those in favor? Yeah, okay, unanimous.
This request involves an appeal of an administrative decision of the Forsyth County Department of Engineering. This property is located in Commission District 5.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. As far as the rules, these are the new rules that were recently adopted. The applicant, who is Mommy's Properties, will go first. The applicant has the burden of proof. You have a total of 45 minutes to present your case. That includes calling any witnesses, presenting any evidence, any documents that you wish to present. Any witnesses that are called will be sworn in, and the county will be have an opportunity to cross-examine those witnesses. They'll be redirect and recross as permitted. After you conclude your presentation by calling all your witnesses, the county would then have an opportunity to call its witnesses. Those would be done one by one. Those witnesses would be subject to cross-examination as well. You may cross-examine those witnesses, and then redirect and recross would be permitted as well. Following the presentation of the witnesses by the applicant and the county, members of the public, anyone speaking in favor of the application or anyone speaking in opposition to the application would have an opportunity to come to the podium and make their presentation. Following that, each side will be presented, the applicant and the county would be permitted up to 10 minutes to present any rebuttal testimony based on the comments offered by the public. You're not required to do that, it's just you're allowed to do that. So we'll kind of see how things go as we get into the hearing. Following that, each side will be permitted up to five minutes for a closing argument. The applicant would have the right to open and conclude the closing argument. Members of the board, you may ask questions at any time. At the conclusion of each witness, I will ask you if you have any questions, and if you do, you can ask, or you can wait until after all the evidence is presented and then ask your questions. So with that said, the applicant, are you ready to proceed?
Yes.
You'll call your first witness, and then if you wish to testify, I'll swear you in.
Before we get going, just it may help him as well. Will there be any presentational aspect to the witness time period? And I apologize, I have not seen the new rules that were adopted this evening.
If each side wants to make an opening statement, you may do so.
Yeah. Do that as part of prior to introducing our witnesses?
Correct, yeah.
Thank you.
As for me, I have no witnesses.
Okay.
And
do you want to make an opening statement?
Yes, so shall I just present what the appeal is?
If you would just tell the board what the evidence or what the issues in the case are, what you plan to prove, and just the nature of your case. Don't go into your whole case, and then let Mr. Frickey make his opening statement, and then we'll begin the evidence.
Okay, you might have to walk me through all the procedural portions of this, so thank you. Hi, my name is Vinay Bose, and I'm going to speak for myself on Mommies Properties, that is the corporation that owns the property. The property is located at 3450 Bentwood Drive, Cumming, 30041. And this appeal is for 180003. And the citation from the Forsyth County inspector to stop work on top soil pasteurization plant that we were doing on our pasture for, it's an equestrian facility. So that work was stopped by the county official, and so that started a chain of events that led to a series of appeals and processes. All five appeals have some relation to each other. And as you see each one of them, you'll get a full picture of exactly what happened. So that's my opinion.
I have prepared some materials which I'll divide into some of it is more of an opening than a presentation of testimony. So it actually dovetails well if I get the AP.
Mr. Buzz indicated that this is an appeal of an administrative decision. An administrative decision, and that administrative decision was a decision by the Department of Engineering to issue and place a stop work order on the property Mr. Buzz described, 3450 Bentwood Drive in Cumming, Georgia. It was issued on December 28, 2017. Just for, and I have these presentations for each of the appeals you're going to hear tonight, but they all apply, they're all the same. It's just a simple presentation as a reminder of what this board's role is in considering this appeal, pulled from the county's Unified Development Code. First is that certainly an appeal may be filed by any aggrieved person. There's no question that Mr. Bose or his company, Mommies Properties LLC, was the owner of the property and would be entitled to that appeal. The appellant is required to set forth the grounds for the appeal, and the ZBA shall consider all facts and materials material to the appeal. Only those the facts and evidence that are related to the specific issue for the particular appeal for which that application was filed. Importantly, this board can only reverse or modify the decision if, after conducting a public hearing, which we'll go through tonight, the ZBA determines that the director was clearly erroneous, and that the decision that was made by the Department of Engineering to issue the stop work order was clearly erroneous. To orient you, you may be somewhat familiar from seeing the appeals, but let me give you some information and show you the property a little bit at the outset. It's 3450. We'll have some testimony to support this, but just for your information, there's the address, the tax parcel. It's got 18 and a half acres in the Chattahoochee River Club subdivision. You'll see it's right near the Chattahoochee River. We'll get someone to identify it, but the testimony will show that red parcel is the parcel. You can see it's not farther from the Chattahoochee River. We'll also hear that there are some streams traversing the property as well. I did something to orient this to you, but if you see that semi-circle, half-moon-ish shape fairly in the middle, a little bit above the middle of this property, that's going to be a riding ring that you see. To the right of that, you'll see a barn, a stable, which will be relevant. To the right then will be, the far right will be some wetlands and eventually the Chattahoochee River. This is an aerial view that will be identified, and actually, as luck would have it, the aerial photometry that was taken earlier this year actually happened to capture the time period when the piles of dirt in question were on the property. You can see them there. You can again see that orientation you've got to the riding stable, kind of the middle, a little bit to the left in the middle, the barn directly in the middle, and the cul-de-sac is upper left corner there. We'll get kind of a reverse view here. Again, looking back from the other side, you can see off to the left that is the wetlands. You can kind of get a sense of where the streams are that are running back of the property. You'll hear some testimony about this. When the County Department of Engineering first went out there looking at this property, this is the ground view. You've seen the overhead view. We give you a little bit of the ground level view, a couple of pictures. You saw that when we were first looking at the riding ring. This is to the left of the riding ring. There was mention of some trenching work. That's a kind of picture of that. And you're standing right at the cul-de-sac entrance to the property. You can see the barn in the background there. The purpose of this picture is trying to give you a sense of this is looking at the back from the back of the barn. You can see the waters that we were talking about just on the side of this kind of somewhat of a little buffer there. This is a copy of the appeal that Mr. Bose on behalf of Mommy's Properties filed. The decision appeal, and this is, I bring this up because it's important to to address each specific appeal as it stands, and that we said, because there, as I said, there are a number of interrelated issues in the sense that it's the same property, and it may be some of the same actions and activities related to cause the issues, but the particular legal decisions that were made by different departments under different laws and subject to different possible exemptions and requirements. So it's important to make sure that we keep in mind what each particular appeal is about. In this case, decision appeals issue a stop work order without prior notice for past duration remediation at 3450 Bentwood Drive, and the decision that a land disturbance permit and grading plan and BMPs were required for the work. And this is the justification that Mommy's Properties included as the grounds for their appeal, saying the stop work order could not be issued under the circumstances without notice to comply. The code and state law provide an exemption for the subject work. The decision to force these codes was politically motivated to please the district commissioner's constituents in the Chattahoochee River Club subdivision. Resident member of the Planning Commission, enforcement decisions are legal void under the Equal Protection Due Process Clause of the state and federal constitution. It will find that county's position will be that none of that was in fact applicable or accurate in this case. Looking at what the law is applicable, looking at the soil erosion and sedimentation control ordinance from which this stop work order was issued, these are sections cited to the Muni Code. There is also, if you may hear reference to Ordinance 73, the way the site plan does, they adopt the ordinance and then it goes up online and the Muni Code renumbers them effectively and creates their own numbering system. They're the same code, just with different numbering systems. This is what the Forsyth County Soil Erosion Sedimentation Control Ordinance requires with respect to whether or not a permit was required. And you don't hear testimony. That was one of the reasons that the stop work order was issued, because there was no permit. It says, no person shall conduct any land-disturbing activity within the jurisdictional boundaries of Forsyth County without first obtaining a permit from the Forsyth County to perform such activity. And then we've got a definition of land-disturbing activity. The key to that is the second dish from the bottom of the line is the transporting of land, transporting of soil, which, as you'll hear, was what was happening to a large extent in this case. In addition, and this is a separate, you'll hear this is a separate rationale, the code, the county's code requires best management practices as set forth in sections 3434 B and C shall be required for all land disturbing activities. Not only do you have to have a permit, that's one requirement, but you also always have to comply with your best management practices. You'll hear it referred to as BMPs a lot. They're separate requirements, and you'll hear they were both part of the rationale for the issuance of the stop work order in this case. What happens if that doesn't occur? What happens if there's no permit and they're not complying with the BMPs? Well, section 3447 indicates that if they do work without first obtaining a permit, the county can issue, and the key part there is they can get an immediate stop work order. That goes to the statement that they're entitled to a notice to comply. This code section right here expressly indicates that where there is a failure to get a permit, they can get an immediate stop work order. Now, obviously, you heard reference to the property and the work on the property being done as an exempt. And I don't think there's any dispute that this is an equestrian facility, and I think even Mr. Bose referred to it as such. And in many jurisdictions, that may be particularly relevant, and here it's actually relevant, but for a different reason. Many jurisdictions might consider that agricultural. As you'll see, that's not the case in Forsyth County with respect to soil erosion sedimentation control. First part of the exemptions is to note that the exemption and specifically only addresses the need for a permit. That only goes to the first half of the equation, the permit half. It does not go to the BMP half of the equation. As you can see further down in this section, it says recipients of an exemption or exception shall be subject to section 3434 minimum requirements and receive to the BMPs. Requiring BMPs. So regardless of whether or not they have an exemption, they still need to comply with the requirements for best management practices, and a stop work order could be put in place for that. Also, in the same code section, see that it's important for purposes of this quasi-judicial hearing, the burden of proving an entitlement to an exemption is on the person seeking that. So Mommy's Properties will need to establish for your sufficiency that they were entitled to the exemption. Well, were they entitled to an exemption? There were two indications that we were aware of from what we could read from the appeal. Most importantly, they mentioned the question activities and the raising and reporting of horses. As I said, in many jurisdictions that might be applicable, but Forsyth County has expressly adopted this language, which certainly recognizes that agricultural operations are entitled to an exemption. However, the Forsyth County Board has elected to specifically exclude the raising and or boarding of horses as part of the agricultural exemption. I think that clearly and unequivocally indicates that this property is not entitled to to the exemption for agricultural uses. Second, and this has been still kind of filtered throughout, I don't know if it was specifically referenced in this particular one, but there is reference to the fact that supposedly disturbed acreage is less than 1 acre. Now, there's an exhibit which shows 77,000 square feet of landscape area on this property. In that original site plan that you had, there's a notation on that. But that being said, if the state water is within 200 feet, then that 1 acre does not apply. That 1 acre minimum does not apply. In fact, you'll hear that there's actually state water on the property itself. Gentlemen, that is why the county is going to, we feel, conclusively prove that the staff worker was in every aspect a appropriate use and enforcement mechanism under the Soil Erosion Sedimentation Control Act, and we'll ask that this board deny the appeal. We'll have that evidence for you after it's our time. Thank you very much.
I was under the impression that was an opening statement because I was going to do my presentation, actually.
Okay.
That was supposed to be the opening statement.
Well, that was
when
your
you presented the whole case.
So
okay.
Now it's time for you to present.
Yeah, I'd like to present the case.
All right,
please.
Raise your hand. You swear a testimony. You swear a firm testimony about to give in this matter be the truth, the whole truth, and then the truth, so help you God.
Yes, I'm presenting the case first. Correct? Okay, thank you. Thank you, Mr. Okay, a couple of points on this exceptions and exemptions. There's could we pull up those pictures of yours if you don't mind? Photographs. Number 8. While they're doing that, the Forsyth County Ordinance actually 73, section 3, number 5 is for agriculture operations, and they do have exceptions and exemptions. Number 8 is actually for less than 1 acre on pages 8 and 9. And this is actually even governed by the state law. So anything that is less than an acre, more than 200 feet from any stream buffer, a stream, need not apply for a permit. So I did not really need grading permit. The other part where Mr. Paul actually said there's 77,000 square feet, yeah, the whole land is 77,000 square feet. Now, exactly what were we doing there? What is this grading? We weren't grading, and that's the entire point. There was no grading. There is no slope that we were taking the third off. This property has been in existence for 23 years, and all that goes on every 6 months, 9 months, a year, year and a half, depending on how badly the horses beat up a pasture, we put topsoil and get it seeded for grass sometime in the fall, late fall. And so this, the seed grows and you try to get whatever pasture you can. This land is has got a pretty wet and saturated and it's a floodplain, so there's very little turnout area for us. And so what little we can do, we do. And we do this turnout, and we have been doing this for a while, for several decades actually. So the this particular instance, why they gave the stop work order is, could you go to, keep scrolling a couple of pictures, yeah, okay. You see where the red circle is? That is four loads of dirt in the morning on December 28th. They stopped us from doing it. That's when we were going to seed that particular pasture. I actually have a close-up picture of that here. May I give this to you? So what, oh, it's too zoomed in. Zoom out, please, if you don't mind. Okay, so this is the same circle area from the previous slide from Mr. Paul. And the area that we were going to pat down, if you see, this paddock is pretty badly beat up, and that's what the horses do. And there is no grass there. But if you show the next picture, this is also what we put a little bit of topsoil and put our seed down and fertilizer. And this is what came about in April. And this is the next pasture next to this. So we do this on a continual basis every year. And if every equestrian facility is supposed to go in and get a permit for every time they topsoil and put grass, it's just not going to work. You'll run all of them out of the county. And the next part of this is on that citation. When I made this application, this appeal for the citation, I did not get a citation, nor did I get a bill for $1,000. They told me that downstairs, that you have a fine associated with it, which is why original application has no, I don't have a fine, because I didn't know I have a fine. I still don't have any citation in my hand that I had a fine. Otherwise, that would have been a separate appeal by itself. And that's where I hand wrote the $1,000 in there initially, because it was, I did not have it even when I filed the appeal. And including in your Forsyth County land disturbance permit webpage, there are all the points that Mr. Paul has already mentioned is there. In could you please go back to the slide? I have one more point. I do not want you all to have this impression that he ran by a slide which has a bobcat there. And there were a couple of pictures of exposed pipes, and I want to explain that. Uh, Could we go through the slides first, if you don't mind, ma'am? Yes, just follow through a few slides. I'll get it. Yes, number eight again. Okay. Yes, yeah. Eight. One more. Oh, the numbers you have here are different from the numbers there.
I haven't introduced them yet.
Sorry.
I'm looking for this picture.
Oh, you can just take it.
Okay.
Here's what started everything. On this, why do we have the conduits and the bobcat there? On this left side where you see there's the earth that has moved out, Swanee cable was on the ground and it got exposed. And so when I called them, they said, well, it is inside your property, so I have to work on it and get it underground. Now that entire area is a one big piece of rock. It's one solid rock from one end to the other. And so the gentleman from Swanee said, you need to get it, move it out, and we will come and put your power cable going all the way to the meter. So that is what happened. If you'll see the next slide over, please, with the conduits. That's why the conduits and the trench was done. And that's where the bobcat belonged to the subcontractor who, and it broke down. So I don't know when they came and got it. They came and got it after a month and a half or so. So this is sometime in fall is when these utilities went in. Atlanta Gas came and laid their gas line there, and the Comcast guys wanted us to put those Comcast conduits in. Now, why are they exposed? Because of the stopped work order. And by the time the subcontractor came and got it and we had the stop work order, we couldn't do anything. They told us we cannot get any physical, mechanical equipment onto the property. So it's still like that even today. And this is where we were stuck. And this has nothing to do with the pasture plan that we were working on. So a 0.03 acres of pasture area is all that we were working on to top soil in December, and we got a stop work order that stopped everything. So this basically helped no one with this stop work order. And it is definitely less than 1 acre, more than 200 feet from the stream, and we have been doing it for 20 odd years. And so for this to pop up suddenly and get a stop order was completely motivated. All the folks that are sitting behind me are all from Chattahoochee Club subdivision, and we have an ongoing dispute about a couple of other title issues which really have nothing to do with this property. And you have a question?
No.
Oh, sorry. So there's a lot of muddled up material that's being brought into this issue, but this is a very simple situation where we do not need a grading permit, or we weren't grading, and so there is nothing to apply for. So there was no need for the stop work order. Thank you.
Ask questions now.
Yeah, please. Any board members have any? Well, you can go ahead and ask your questions.
Do you have any testimony from Comcast saying that you needed to bury the pipes, or that they told you that was the procedure?
No, they told me that the trench was dug for Swanee Power, and Atlanta Gas came and didn't bury there because Atlanta Gas was coming. So they dug some more. At which point we were getting our I was asking for Comcast or AP180003,
They told me they'll only come up to the street. So we laid the conduit for Comcast. So Comcast didn't come inside the property. Atlanta Gas did, and Swanee Power did.
But do you have anything from them saying that that's why you needed to dig the ditch or anything? Anything to support what you told us?
No. Okay. I didn't dig the ditch. The utilities dug the ditch. And the ditch has nothing to do with this application. So you're asking the same question here, which is exactly what I'm arguing, that the ditch has nothing to do with the stop work order.
Okay.
Thank you.
Any other questions at this time? All right, cross-examination, Mr. Frickey.
Mr. Bose, I'll ask you a few questions since you testified. And you indicated that you you've done decades worth of pasteurization of the property?
Decades worth, yes.
And how long have you owned the property?
13 years.
Okay. And do you own
it? I would like to clarify that the property is 23 years old. Okay. And for decades, they've been working on it the way we have. What we were doing.
Were you working on it prior to your ownership?
Prior to my ownership in 2005?
Correct.
No.
Do you own any other property?
But I knew how they were working on it, if that helps you.
Okay. Do you own any other property, or does any company that you own any other property? Do you develop other properties?
No.
Mommy's property doesn't own anything?
No.
You're not picking up. Can you use the microphone, please?
Have you ever developed any other properties?
Yes.
In December of 2017, were you developing any other properties?
No, not mine.
Not yours, but someone else's?
I have a big group of friends and family, and everybody owns some property or the other. So there's always work going on at properties all across Atlanta.
Okay.
Yes.
And the piles of dirt that we saw on the pictures, I mean, you don't dispute that they were brought in by dump trucks, correct?
Correct.
How many total were going to be brought on?
I believe it was six or seven, or seven or eight. I'm not sure, but it's
where were you getting
it? It's in a single-digit number. They were coming from three different places, actually.
Okay. And did you have any evidence of? Did you purchase it?
Purchase it?
The dirt.
No, I didn't buy the dirt. Is that what you're asking?
Yes.
No.
Okay. Have you ever bought dirt?
Yes.
Do you have any evidence of that?
For a software project?
Correct.
Evidence that I bought dirt?
Correct.
Yeah, sure.
Do you have it here for this evening for the board?
Oh, no, I don't. This is the first time you're asking me a question whether I bought dirt, which has nothing to do with a pasture plan on a 0.3 acres.
Okay. And there's strings on the property, correct?
Yes.
And do you ever go out and check the gate across the cul-de-sac entrance to the property?
Gate across cul-de-sac?
Your property's at the end of a cul-de-sac, correct?
Right.
Bentwood Drive?
Right.
Okay. And there's a gate across the entrance to the stables, correct?
Gate across, as in opposite to?
A gate.
You mean gate entrance to the property?
Yes.
To our property?
Yes.
Yes, sure. That's the white gate?
Yes.
Yes. What about it? That's where the stop work order was put.
So you did see the stop work order placed there?
No, I did not. I saw it later. I did not see it. Mr. Pruitt, who actually put the first stop work order, called me on the phone.
Okay.
And that's what he said he was doing.
When was the first time you went to check it?
Pardon me?
When was the first time you went to check?
Holy moly. It must have been a few days later. I think, I don't remember, maybe the following week.
And was there a stop work order on the gate?
It actually had fallen down, and they came and put it back up again.
So you have seen it?
Well, sure, I've seen it.
Okay.
I have pictures of it.
Okay.
But I did not get any notice about the stop work order in the mail.
The only notice you got was posted on the fence, on the gate.
It, correct. Okay. Correct.
Is your pasteurization plan is to plant in the fall, correct?
Well, usually that is the best time. You put topsoil and then you put one more layer of good manure material and get your seeds in so they seed over winter, and then in spring you would see the effect of what I showed you.
And you probably wouldn't drive over that stuff that you've put down, right?
No, so let me finish. So that is what you do for the grass part of it. Now there are some other pastures where we block off a certain area if it's really beat up and go ahead and topsoil that area and pasture it as well, and we close it. So it has enough time to regenerate. But this is not grading. It's important to know that this is not grading. You're not grading anything. It's not going anywhere. It's just sitting on top.
And the trucks drove from Bentwood Drive back to the back portion where the topsoil was dumped, correct?
Sure. We have a few ways to get to the property, but there was a tree that fell, so we stopped coming to Bentwood Drive.
But they did drive across the property to get the soil and dump it there.
Get across our property, you mean from the main gate?
From wherever the property line was.
Yes.
Okay. And just to be clear, there's no question this isn't an equestrian facility. The barn is there for horses, and there's a riding rink out in front of it, correct?
Correct.
And the paddocks are for horses to hang out.
I'm sorry, what are you saying?
The paddocks that you mentioned,
yes.
That's for horses.
Paddocks are for horses, yes. And whatever activities they do, it's not only for horses.
What's the longest
they
time?
Have, what's the longest? The paddocks are also for the activities that go on, lessons and events and whatever they do.
Yes. The commercial events that go on?
Well, define commercial. As
you said, what type of events go on?
They have parties, they have some writing lessons, they do some charity, whatever they do for their, there's a therapy session, an equestrian therapy session. That I do not run that part of the equestrian portion of it. So somebody who owns the horses usually runs.
Okay, thank you.
Mr. Neville? Oh, you don't have to ask any questions at this time.
Sure.
In the calendar year 2017, did you have any other periods where you brought in additional topsoil?
Yes.
And do you recall approximately when that was?
Actually, even M10, I think it was summer. Yeah, I don't know the exact dates. But the arena that Mr. Paul had mentioned before, it has this very thin cotton material called M10, and that's the area where they do the training for horses and kids and all their events. So that also gets changed, and what we do is we actually scrape off the top. That's why you use a water cap to scrape off the top and then reinstall the layer back again.
So approximately how many times would you say during the course of that year was soil brought?
You mean last year?
In 2017.
17. I think it's at least twice.
So the bobcat was there by a subcontractor to get the pipe stuff and not to scrape the topsoil?
No. There are two different things. Okay, let me clarify again. this particular bobcat in that picture is some subcontractor's bobcat that broke down. And the guy who actually did the digging and the, but I, what I don't know is whether it's the power or the gas guy.
Right, but you don't have any communication or anything, say, from whoever owned the bobcat saying that's my bobcat?
No, they're subcontractors. We just dealt with the with whatever meter installation people from power and gas.
Okay.
Yeah. So you didn't hire that contractor. That contractor was hired by.
Yeah. Usually the utility company itself has their own.
So it's their sub, not yours.
No. Yeah. But yes, the bobcat or whatever equipment is used. There are a couple of gentlemen who keep coming and doing that, and then they scrape the dust. There's horse manure, and they beat up the soil, you know, that's horses. So they do use a bobcat. We have always used a bobcat to even the soil or lay soil. Yes.
But it was a different bobcat than the
correct. Okay. Three different bobcats on this.
Okay. Yeah. I was a little confused because I wasn't sure whether you were saying that this bobcat was being used for moving manure, or this bobcat was for trenching.
This is for the trench, whatever the subcontractor. I don't know these people.
Any other questions about the members of the board? Mr. Bose, do you have any other witnesses?
No, sir. I don't have witnesses.
All right. Do you rest your case? Do you have any exhibits you want to present or anything like that?
Yes. What I do want to say is there is a lot of information on this, and Mr. Paul did present how an equestrian farm is not exempt from requiring a grading in the agriculture area. So there's a distinction there, and the distinction is this. Agriculture, they would do their tilling and they'll be disturbing that soil all day long, whereas that's not the case in an equestrian facility. They will only do it to get the pasture going. And not all pastures get beat up like ours. We have a very small pasture area. I mean, for this barn has some 25 stalls in there. And we can never have 25 horses there because there is no turnout. For each horse, you need an X amount of area. And we don't have that. So that's the difference. That's why it needs a lot more work. And if you see a few more pictures that is there in the package, we have to keep bringing hay from outside. There's no way to grow grass as a real pasture for the horses. And so the 33, 34 that Mr. Paul was talking about is not applicable because it is the state law which has much more precedence than the county does. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Mr. Bose. Mr. Bose read our Mommies Properties LLC in the Alvarez's case.
On 003, yes.
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 All right, you can have a seat.
Thank you.
Mr. Frickey, if you want to present the county's case, call your first witness.
Thank you. Actually, and I believe I'll have an agreement with Mr. Bose at the County Unified Development Code and Ordinance 73. The certified copies be tendered into evidence.
No objection.
All right, what are those?
I've marked Exhibit 1, the Unified Development Code, and Exhibit 2, the Ordinance 73, which is the Soil Erosion and Sedimentation Control Ordinance.
Okay, and then without objection.
For the purpose of this evening, we can address this as we go on, but I would tender a certified copy for each of the appeals this evening. I brought a single copy to save on caffeine. We can get multiple originals if that is the board's or the hearing officer's desire. But, address that. The first witness we'd like to call is Doug Briggs.
Mr. Briggs, can you raise your right hand? Swear affirm the testimony you're about to give this matter of the truth, all the truth, and nothing but the truth, so help me God.
I'm getting a straight to you, formally state your name to the board.
My name is Doug Briggs. I'm a code enforcement officer for Forsyth County.
Thank you very much. And are you familiar with the property at 3450 Bentwood Drive? Did you have reason to be on the property on December 28, 2017?
About 10:30 in the morning, I received a complaint from the county administration that there was activity on the property. I've been out there before. Mr. Boyce had asked me not to go on the property without him, so I went out there, but I was in the cul-de-sac in front of the property.
Did you witness activity on the property?
While I was there, there was a black pickup truck, a gentleman named Mr. John Harris, a hauling contractor, and I noticed that there were 4 piles of dirt brought in. That was the complaint that morning. It said 7:30 that the dirt had been brought in.
And Mr. Neville, if it please you, and I have a package of exhibits that I will be looking to present, maybe not quite in order. May I present the full package, and you can tender them as they become appropriate?
Show them to Mr. Bose, if you would. Has he seen them?
Mr. Bose, you have
a This is the same package you gave me.
Do you have any objection to that, Mr. Bose?
No objection, sir.
What are they numbers?
I have numbers 3 through 15.
All right, then it's not good.
And may I distribute a copy of each set to the board members? And I'll bring you a copy as well. Attention to exhibit 14 in the packet. And why don't you tell me what that is?
That's a picture of the pasture that I took containing the 4 loads of dirt.
And those of dirt, where are they on this picture?
Which picture?
In the
14.
Center. In the center?
Right in the middle of the picture. And that was taken on the December 28th when you went out there?
Right, in the day of the
And maybe not quite clear, but how many loads of dirt did you see?
There were 4.
And did it appear to be dump truck loads?
Yes.
Are those the only trucks hauling dirt that you saw on that day?
No, while I was talking to Mr. Harrison, the cul-de-sac, he had agreed to stop bringing the dirt in, and until it was clarified whether they could store it there. And that, because that was his statement, he said it was coming from the property owners of the project and they were going to store the dirt there. And then while we were standing there, 3 more dump trucks came and pulled that.
Did he say anything about pasture remediation?
No.
What did you do as a result of hearing that's what was going on?
I told him to hold off until I checked the supervisor and I called Tom Brown and I knew there was no permits on the site for site development or for any construction work. And I said, asked him if the storage of the dirt was okay. And he inquired about a stop work order. And I said, normally we defer issues with ground clearances, site work to the engineering department. So I called Shane, Kroell from the engineering department, I got his voicemail within his top contact in the engineering department, and Shane showed up a couple weeks later.
Did you do anything further with respect to inspection or enforcement on the property on December 28th? No. All the questions I have for Mr. Briggs.
All right, cross examination. Bose.
Mr. Briggs?
Yes.
Hi. Vinay, you finally came in. Yes. You called me on December 28th, right? Do you remember calling me on December 28th?
No, I didn't. I don't remember calling you.
How did you get my number first?
I talked to you earlier, get into my notes, on the 14th, I think it was, that you were supposed to meet. There was a complaint about the activity inside the stadium, and you asked me on the 14th not to go on the property without you because I might misinterpret what was being done, the repairs being done for new construction. And I agreed to that. And we had set up an appointment, I think it was January 4th, because you were the one that was having some surgery or something like that. And the holiday weekend, everything like that, I said that'd be fine. And then you were in the county, and on advice of your attorney, you said you didn't want to meet me that day, so we did do the inspection.
How did you land up at the property on December 28th?
I went there based on a complaint from administration.
Administration? Who administration?
The deputy county manager, Kim Merrick, sent an email to my administrative assistant, and I got a copy of that since my supervisor was out of town, and I put it up to the property, to the cul-de-sac in front of the property.
And who's your supervisor in the county?
My supervisor, Steve Zarek.
Steve Zarek. Mm-hmm. Is he present here?
Yeah. He was out of town that week at some wedding.
Oh, okay. Previously in December, did Mr. Zarek ask you to call me about activity on the farm? Why did you call me when you called me in December?
I got a complaint. About activity in the disabled building.
From whom, sir?
I believe it came from administration.
Administration, right. Mr. Zarin.
No, it came from the commissioner's office.
Commissioner's office. Which commissioner?
It was forwarded to the county administration.
Okay. So, just so I get this clear, somebody from the commissioner's office contacted the administration who's in charge of your department, and they contacted you, and you're the field person that came to the site. Okay, so that's how this whole thing unfolded. Okay, and did you get any pictures from the administration? Any photographs? No.
No, I just recall that there was mention of
okay. So, Mr. Neville, I'm showing the witness, Mr. Briggs, exhibits from Mr. Paul, exhibits number 3 onwards. Did you take this image or picture?
No.
Exhibit number 3.
No.
No. Did you take a picture of exhibit number 5?
No.
Did you take a picture of exhibit number 6?
No.
Did you take a picture of number 7?
No.
Did you take a picture of number 8?
No.
Did you take a picture of number 9? Did you take a picture of number 10? Did you take a picture of number 11? Well, that's your citation, I'm sorry.
No.
Right, it's not yours. Is this your citation number 12, sir?
No.
Is it not yours? Oh. Number 13, did you take this picture?
No.
No. Number 14, did you take this picture?
Yes.
Where did you take this picture from, sir?
From the front gate.
From the front gate of the barn? From the cul-de-sac?
Front gate. Oh,
right? The gentleman in the truck that were coming and dropping the dirt, did you ask them why they were putting dirt in that particular pasture?
Mr. Briggs, could you step up and speak in the microphone? It's really hard to hear you.
I don't remember exactly how you came about explaining to me why they were bringing the dirt there, but he volunteered, you know, the explanation that they were just going to store it there. And it was coming from another one of your projects.
Okay. So, but you do not know whether that is true or false, or whether you got good information or bad information.
Right.
No way for you to check that.
No way.
Okay. Did we have a conversation about it?
As I recall, you were talking, I did not recall.
No, did you and I have a conversation about death? We did not.
No.
That's all I have, sir.
All right. Thank you.
Mr. Ball?
Thank you, Mr. Gracie. Have a seat. Mr. Frickey, next witness.
Thanks, Paul Shane Green.
Drew, would you raise your right hand and swear or affirm the testimony about to give in this matter be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth to help you out?
I'll do. Can you state your name and position?
Shane Brooks, I can solve the road inspector.
And are you familiar with the property at 3450 Bentwood Drive?
Yes, sir.
Were you on the property in mid-December of 2017?
Yes.
When was the first time you went out there in that time frame?
12-11. I was there to talk to my supervisor that he received a complaint for me to meet him on site. So I met him out there on site.
And I'm just going to show you a couple of these. Looking at Exhibit 3, and I'm just going to walk you through these quickly. Do you recognize 3450 Bentwood Drive on this?
Yes, in the red.
And is this a survey or just a general?
Just a general.
Have you seen Exhibit 4 before?
Yes.
And does that depict the subject property?
Yes.
Can you just give a kind of just a general orientation on what you see on that property with respect to what's actually out of the?
The cul-de-sac would be, there would be a double gate, the entrance. I believe the ladder type would be the driveway. The half moon shape would be the riding ring. The checkered shape there in the center would be the stables. Looking at it the way I'm looking at it, the back left corner, there would be a red barn. Behind that, where the line is, or the, you would have a, like a marsh land in there. So, anybody else?
Are you familiar with the fact that there's an issue with respect to piles of dirt, piles of soil on this property in this case?
Yes.
Is there any indication you can indicate, any reference you can point to where you saw the piles of dirt?
Yes, on the, if you look where I showed where the red barn was, yeah, if you're looking at this, if you're coming from the entrance in into the stables, to your right and below the checkered markings there, a little bit further to the right, a little bit left where the four lungs dirt where they drop.
Ballpark. Tell you what.
Yes.
Okay. We move to Exhibit 5. Would this
picture depict the property as you saw it from an overhead view, that same drawing that you just had?
Yes.
And you pick out a few monuments in there that you recognize? Sure, yeah.
Yeah, the very white thing would be the stable, the roof line of the stable. And in front of that would be the half moon, the riding ring. South of that, where the red circle is, that would be about where the four rows of dirt were dropped.
And would you say, I mean, you didn't take that picture, did you?
The aerial picture?
Right.
No.
But does it accurately depict the property when you were out there?
Quick question, if I may. This was December the 11th, correct? Roughly, or
we're going to start with December 11th. So far, it has been yes.
Okay, that was my question. Yeah.
And moving on to Exhibit 6, does this appear to depict the same site from the opposite side, an aerial view?
Yes.
And any indication of where the dirt was located?
Yes, that's pretty appropriate.
And that's where that red circle is?
Right? Yes, where the red circle is.
Now moving to 7. Just for purposes of just showing us the base level, this is a ground level view picture that you took, correct?
Yes.
And this was taken on December 11th, the first time you were there? And Exhibit 8 as well, you took that?
Yes.
And where is that taken from?
This would have been taken from the entrance and the cul-de-sac. Okay. Looking back into it.
You took Exhibit 9?
Yeah, I took all these pictures. These pictures were probably actually taken on the 12th. Okay. Because I was asked to go back out on the 12th and take more photos.
So the next day?
Yes.
Okay. So Exhibit 7, 8, and 9 were taken on the 12th?
Yes.
Okay. Did anything change between the 11th and the 12th?
No, sir.
Did you take Exhibit 10?
Yes.
What, looking kind of the top middle of that picture, what's that kind of glint there?
Water. Okay. Slightly water.
And as we stand here today, is it your testimony that there are state waters on this property?
Yes, sir.
Okay, before we move on to the next exhibit, did you have cause to go back out there after the 11th and 12th?
I received one more call from Doug Briggs with code enforcement that there was a flatbed truck down there. They didn't know what they were doing. I rode out there, the truck was gone, I turned and left.
And what day did you say that was?
That was on the 18th.
Did you have cause to be out on the property on December 28th?
Yes, December 28th, I received a call from Doug Briggs, code enforcement, that they were all in there to the site. So Doug left me a message and I called him back and he told me that they were all in there, and so I went out to the site.
And what did you find when you got to the site?
There had been 4 10 loads of dirt dumped on the site. Doug Briggs told me that there was more dirt to come. As far as the amount, I didn't get in a whole lot of the amount issued. I saw that they were moving in dirt. But I think Doug did mention something about there were 6 7 8 loads of dirt somewhere in there that was supposed to come in.
What did you do in terms of a enforcement type action with respect to the property on December 28th?
Well, I went and inspected. I took photos of the dirt, inspected the site, saw that the dirt had been brought in. And I asked you to stop work with $1,000 fine.
I'm looking at Exhibit 13. Is that a picture that you took?
Yes, sir.
And Would appear there's four loads of dirt, correct?
Yes.
With some lines in there, do you have an indication of what that might be?
That's probably where the trucks came in, turned around and backed up and dumped the dirt.
With your familiarity with the code, with the Soil Erosion Sedimentation Act, how broad would land disturbing activities be? Would it be limited to grading?
No.
What other activities might constitute land disturbing activities? And I've got the code, but just in your, what do you look for?
Grading, dredging, transporting, anything that creates movement of the soil is land disturbance. Okay.
Based on what you viewed personally on the property, did you do anything with respect to enforcement? Did you take any actions to enforce the Soil Sedimentation Erosion Control Act?
Yes.
What did you do?
I issued a stop work with the federal government.
Okay. And what was what were the reasons for the issuance of that stop work order?
Well, I saw it as he's hauling in dirt. He's bringing in dirt. In order to do that, in the ordinance 73, you have to have a permit to bring in dirt on a commercial site.
Was having a permit the only reason for the issuance of the stop work order?
No, they were, first of all, you got, you're transporting in dirt on site with no BMPs. And you also have state water on the site.
Did you witness any best management practices with respect to this these loads of dirt?
No.
And was that one of the reasons you issued the stop work order?
Yes. All those things have to be in consideration.
What are some of the best management practices you would need to take?
In this case, steel fence.
Between the dirt and the water?
Yeah, around the perimeter to keep that sediment in case of the rains from washing that sediment down into the marshes or the streams.
How close to the marsh was the dirt?
I did not measure it.
Give me an estimate.
But it was 150 feet from the actual bank of the marsh.
The dirt, was it clean dirt or did it have rocks in it?
No, just dirt. I didn't expect it. It was just dirt. It didn't look very rocky.
So it could have been used for topsoil?
I'll make it so.
Looking at exhibits 11 and 12, are you familiar with those two documents?
Yes.
And what's exhibit 11?
This is a red card stop work notice. This is posted on site. When we issue a stop work, we put the address, the parcel, the issues, while we're placing the stop work, the date, time, and the inspector.
Did you personally post that?
Yes, sir.
And when did you post it?
12/28/2017.
And recognize exhibit 12?
Yes.
And what is that?
That is a form we accompany, we fill out, and while we're filling out the red card, this is the first one that we fill out. This document here is filled out. There's a copy of this posted on site. Then there's a copy of this sent certified mail to the owner of the property.
And do they indicate the reasons for the issuance of the stop work order?
Yes.
And what reasons did you include in your reason for issuing the stop work
order? No land disturbance permit, no BMPs in place, and no lot grading plan.
I
you said you issued $1,000 in fines. What was that related to?
The same as not permanent.
Could there have been any fines assessed with respect to the lack of BMPs?
Yes.
But you didn't assess any, can you assess any fines for the lack
no.
of
BMPs? Mr. Paul, what's a BMP?
Best management practices, BMPs. As we stand here today, do you believe any exemptions would have prevented the addition to the stop work order?
No.
Do you think the agriculture exemption would apply to this stop work order?
No.
And do you think that, and why is that?
Because in ordinance 73, it clearly specifies that under that particular exemption that the raising and boarding of horses is specifically excluded from being able to get that exemption.
And Mr. Mommies' property says suggested that they were exempt because they were serving less than 1 acre. Do you believe that exemption applied in this case? Do you consider that?
Well, it's not a single family residence. So that less than acre would not apply. Also, the fact that it had state waters on that property excludes him from an exemption.
Any other questions I have this time?
Thank you.
Hey, Mr. Gray.
Hello.
Oh, yes.
Do you recall when we spoke for the first time, sir?
Yes, on the phone.
When was that?
12:28. After I placed the stop work, I gave Mr. Vinay a call. That's part of our protocol is we have to get in contact with him on it.
Do you recall what you told me why you gave me the stop work order?
Yes. I told Mr. Bose that I was placing the stop work because of no land disturbance permit, and that would carry $1,000 fine. And there was no silt fence, no BI. I think I used the word silt fence in place.
And do you recall telling me that anytime there's a dump truck on property, you need to get a permit?
No, not anytime there's a dump truck on property. But any time that you're dumping dirt in the manner which it's being dumped, you have to have a permit.
Now, you said you came to the property the first time on December 11th.
Yes.
Why did you not tell me about that on December 28th when we spoke? Any particular reason?
No. It wasn't asked. It was irrelevant.
So, you took these pictures. Let's go over these photographs here in this exhibit. Mr. Paul, did you take this for this image number three, exhibit number three?
This one right here?
Yes.
For the red one? No.
Yes, you did not. So, just flip through this real quick, okay? Number four? No, it's just my exhibit. Number five?
The aerial, I did not take.
The aerial of the farm, number six?
No, I took no aerial.
Did you take exhibit number seven?
Yes.
Exhibit seven. Did you take exhibit eight?
Yes.
This was on what date? 7 and 8?
That would have been 12/12/2017.
This number, okay. And exhibit nine?
Yes.
Okay. Exhibit 10?
Yes.
Where did you take this picture, exhibit 10 from?
This is, if you're going into the entrance from the cul-de-sac, this would have been to the left and to the back rear of the stable.
Who the other one should go back
there? Nobody.
So you just entered on your own?
Yes.
Did you jump over the gate?
No, I crawled through it.
Okay. 11, did you take this picture?
Yes.
When did you take this picture?
I'm not sure of when that was taken. I'll have to look.
Okay, no worries.
I mean, I've got it here, I can look it up.
Let me try. Okay, all right, let's move on. Exhibit number 12.
There you go. That's the form that is certified mail from the for the issuer.
Do you have a certified mail return receipt?
No, I don't. I wouldn't get that.
Does your administration get it?
I don't know. I wouldn't get it.
Did you personally mail it?
No.
Who mails it?
We turn that in to the administration and let them know.
Do you know whether I got your mail or not?
That I couldn't know, sir.
Okay. Exhibit number 13, did you take this picture, sir?
Yes, sir.
Did you go inside the property and take this picture?
Yes, sir.
Again, did you crawl through the fence?
No, the gate was open.
Oh, did you meet anybody there?
No.
You didn't see
anybody? I mean, this photo was taken the day that the dirt was actually dumped. And I had met Doug out there.
So this was on December 28th?
Yes.
And exhibit number 14?
No, can you flip it around?
Yeah, sure.
No, I didn't take it. I think this is Doug's photo.
Okay. Exhibit number 15?
No, I didn't post that one.
Do you know who posted this sign?
I think that would have been planning the new stuff.
Now, we went through a series of these photographs, right? Matthew, if you go to the previous slides, just a couple more before. Yeah. Okay, you know the one, the previous, the same one you had before. That one. All right, let's start with that. You see that picture?
Mr. Yeah. Bird?
Okay. This picture you saw on the land, would you say that the land is disturbed?
Well, you do have the right to go in and place utilities.
Why then did you stop me from buying them?
Because at that time, they were the stop work placed.
Okay.
Not at this time, but I didn't tell you that until the stop work was placed.
No, sir.
We met outside. And we reiterated why the stop work was being placed. And I told Mr. Bose that until the stop work issue was resolved, there needed to be no more land disturbance on that side.
Okay. So you already saw that the land was disturbed?
Yeah.
On the 11th?
Right.
But you did not give any citation for it?
Right, because you are allowed to go in without a permit and install utilities.
Okay, so wouldn't it be prudent to bury those utilities?
Yeah, and most utility companies, they will not leave that site until their utilities are buried.
Right.
I used to work for utilities.
Did you see that bobcat picture that you showed me before?
Yes.
Okay. Do you know whether that bobcat was broken down?
I have no idea.
Okay. There was a flatbed that somebody told you came on the 18th.
Yeah, they said there was one out in that area in the cul-de-sac, so I'm not sure.
Would you happen to know whether that flatbed picked up that bobcat?
I have no idea.
Was it possible that that bobcat would have been picked up by the flatbed?
Yeah, I guess it could. Yeah.
What are the uses of flatbed?
Huh?
What are the uses of flatbed?
Okay, how is that relevant to the issue about whether
there was a land disturbance violation and stop work order was issued. I think everybody concedes that you were not issued a stop work order based on utilities or bobcats or anything like that. So let's see if we can focus on just the issue about that.
They are closely related, and I'm glad you brought it up, sir, because none of this line of the entire presentation of the case itself went haywire the minute it went outside of where what I owned. It had nothing to do with what the land disturbance is, but you allowed that, sir. So I would like to ask him if the bobcat, which is such a big issue for, let me finish, sir, please, is such a big issue for grading, is the bobcat. And if he did not find the need to cite me for a piece of equipment that's already there, and he already said if you get dump trucks with dirt, they're closely related. And that's where I'm going with this, unless you want to stop me.
May I ask a question?
Yes, sir.
Go ahead.
Sir,
yes.
Was the bobcat in question here related in any way with the disturbance?
The utilities, the photos we took on the 11th, on the 11th and the 12th, they had no relevance to the stop work.
Perfect.
And that's where my question goes is, so why did you, after you got the stop order, do you remember me asking you, can I at least bury the utilities? And you said no.
Yeah, I did tell him that.
Okay.
Because the stop work had already been issued.
That was going to be my question.
So I did not tell him that before. I never made contact with him until I issued the stop work.
So he had between the 11th.
And the time of
and the 28th,
you to stop.
So we have 17 days to bury the cable.
To bury those utilities.
I'm missing a point. So, because a piece of equipment can't come before Christmas during that period, you cannot do it anymore. Is that the point?
No, I just asked the question. I just said you had 17 days to bury it.
It was longer than that because their equipment broke down.
Yeah, he actually had longer than that because it was a few weeks after that that I told him he could not do any more land disturbance. So he actually had longer than the 17 days.
Well, it broke down, but I don't know exactly what dates. So now, you said something about state. Do you know if the state, are you familiar with the Georgia Soil and Water Conservation?
Yes, sir.
Okay. You're familiar with the ordinance number 73, right?
Yes.
For equestrian facilities, is it agriculture only?
For what?
Okay. The exemption is for agriculture except for equestrian facilities in 73.
It is for agriculture.
Correct.
For things that are zoned agriculture. This site is not zoned agriculture, it is a commercial site.
Do you know the delineation of how much commercial and how much agriculture is on this?
I'm not sure right now.
Okay. Do you agree that in the ordinance it says less than 1 acre or 200 feet from a stream? You do not need a land disturbance permit.
But because of what?
I don't know, that's in the ordinance.
I mean, what are you saying? We don't have within the waters?
No.
Okay.
Less than 1 acre.
Uh-huh.
Are you familiar with anything in your books that says less than one
yes.
acre, you do not need a land disturbance
yes.
permit? Okay.
Yeah, a single family residence, that can get an exemption from the land disturbance permit. But this being a horse stable, I don't think that's considered a single family residence.
And agriculture?
No, it is a commercial site.
My question is, for agriculture, less than 1 acre.
For agriculture,
yes.
Less than 1 acre?
Yes.
Yeah, if they could prove they were entitled to that exemption, they could probably get that exemption.
Okay. Did you ask me to get that exemption?
No, because from what I've heard, you were not entitled to any exemptions.
Are you familiar with the Georgia Soil and Water Conservation Commission?
Yes.
Are you familiar with OCGA 12717?
I'll have to look at you. I'll share with you.
It's a manual for erosion and sediment.
Right.
Okay. So, would you read this?
Yes. I haven't seen what he's.
Yeah, come on.
And this is the Georgia Soil and Water that you're getting this at.
First of all, what are you presenting that as?
I'm just asking him to read it, to see if he's familiar with it.
You're telling him what it is?
No, I'm asking him what it is. Go ahead, sir.
This is the Georgia Soil and Water Conservation Commission. But the question in my stop work was not based on this. My stop work is based on Ordinance 73 of Forsyth County. That is covering the state general permit. I enforce Ordinance 73 for South County.
So are you familiar with these two? Did you read them? 4, 5, and 8?
Well, Jeff, he didn't use them as the basis for a staff report, so they're completely irrelevant.
I'm trying to establish if the Ordinance 73 is in sync with the Georgia Erosion Control.
Yes, it is, Mom. I can read it to you out of the Forsyth County.
It's one of the
Ordinance 73.
One of the same. In fact, that is exactly not the situation. The key to this is they are not one of the same. That's why this is irrelevant. Ordinance 73 is relevant.
How is it relevant that? Why is state law relevant when we're talking about an ordinance violation, a county ordinance violation?
My point. State law, state grants county all the laws that it can have. And so it's pretty clear in Georgia statute. That's my reading. But
you're not, you're not being cited for a state law violation, you're being cited for a county ordinance violation.
Right. So it is. Even, but the state law supersedes the county law and ordinance.
Not in this situation.
So it allows less than one acre. All I'm showing is mere consistency between the state and county, where you have the ability to do what we have been doing for years on an area less than 1 acre.
I'll sustain
0.03 in this.
I'll sustain the objection. I think you ought to just focus on the county ordinance.
May I say something concerning that? What he's talking about, that the state, Forsyth County is a local issue authority. And under the state laws, Forsyth County, the local issue authority, has the right. They have the authority to, as far as project size, we have the authority to actually minimize. We don't have the authority to exceed, but we do have the authority to minimize. Not only with land disturbance, but only buffers, state water buffers. There's several things, and I don't have them here in front of me, that the local issue authority has the right to be more stringent on than the state. We can't be less stringent, but we can be more stringent.
In other words, actually, so what you're saying is, the state says less than 1 acre you can do what I was doing, and you're saying you cannot say less than 2 acres, but not less than 1 acre. Is that right?
Yeah. What I'm saying is the state tells me that it tells Forsyth County, you have the right, as far as project size, you have the right to make that smaller. So if we deem that you have to have, the state may say you have to have 1 acre. Forsyth County can say, well, we've moved that to a half acre.
Did you? Did Forsyth move it to half an acre? Or does it still say the books less than 1 acre?
It's still less than 1 acre.
Thank you. That's exactly
but
what
have, we have that right.
Less than 1 acre. Thank you.
Excuse me. The 1 acre, is that for all classes of zoning, or is that restricted to the residential only?
That is a single. In the book, it's a single family residence. It's actually less than 1 acre.
This is CBD property.
Yes, this is a commercial site.
So when ordinarily when you would look at a site like this, you would have, whether it was, you know, because you could, the soil could have been confined to a quarter of an acre, but it would still apply to the whole site.
Yes, and that goes back to the to it being, there being state waters on this property. It's not an issue of whether what he's doing is within 200 feet of state waters. The issue is that he has state waters on his property. So he's not exempt from that. It doesn't matter what the work's being done on the site. It's that project within a whole, if it's within 200 feet.
So it's less than 200 feet. Okay, so there is an exemption. You're just talking about the size of it now, right?
No, I'm talking about that your site has state waters on it. So that excludes from any exemption.
Oh, so you're saying state waters on the property, so no matter what, no law applies to it. There are no rights with any exemptions.
Well,
Go ahead and ask.
State waters on this particular property, it is your responsibility to find out what you're responsible for when you take measures on this property, because there is state water on this property. Therefore, even if there was not a land disturbance, let's say that Mr. Bose, he did get an exemption. Let's say he got a, I'm just speaking hypothetical, he did get, let's say he got an agricultural exemption. But he is not exempt from his BMPs and protecting and ensuring that that settlement does not enter into the state waters on that site, regardless of where it is.
Now, you're talking about grading, right?
No, I didn't issue the stop work for grading. I issued the stop work for land disturbance, and that includes not only grading, but bringing in dirt and stockpiling dirt, which that will be the case. As far as the grading, no, that's...
You got the word stockpiling from where?
Well, that's what it is. There's four loads of dirt that have been dumped on the site with more dirt to come. The only way that I can phrase that is that's stockpiling dirt.
Okay.
So how much? So I don't know.
Are you aware that you put the dirt, bring the dirt in, and then you do what you have to do with it? Or are you saying that you cannot put the dirt if you cannot immediately work on it? Is that what you're saying?
I'm saying in order to do what you were doing before you brought in the dirt, you were supposed to get a land disturbance permit from Forsyth County.
No, sir. We're talking about stockpiling is my question. My question is, you're saying stockpiling as if I'm going to leave it there. In your mind, how long do you think I was going to leave it there?
How long did you leave it there?
No, I'm asking the question. Are you aware that you didn't let me do anything with it?
Yes, I am. That is what a stop work issue means. Correct. That all land disturbance activity on that site
is
stopped.
Isn't it true that you made me stop pile it?
I didn't make you stop pile it.
So what was I supposed to do with it?
I don't know, but, and that's a question that I've got. What happened to the dirt?
So, you understand the question, right?
Yeah, but okay. And that's what I would like to know as an inspector, because I went back there on 2/15/2018, and the dirt was gone.
Where was it gone?
That I don't know. But that is considered land disturbance too, because there was supposed to be no work done while that stop work was in place. And when I went out there on 12/15/2018, those four loads of dirt were gone.
Aren't you aware, do you remember telling me that the dirt cannot be on the property?
No, I didn't make the decision whether it was there or whether it lay on.
No, sir. I know you didn't make any decision. My question is, do you recall telling me that the dirt shouldn't be on the property?
No, I never told you that. That wasn't... I told you that you had brought it in and you needed the permit to do that. That's why I placed the stop work.
Okay. That's all right. Thank you.
Can I ask a question?
Yes.
On
on your, what on this exhibit 12, there's an option for issuing a, a warning or a stop work order. And you chose to do the stop work order. I'm just curious, would a warning have been applicable in this situation?
In some situations, we do. I mean, but when there's a threat to state waters, we issue an immediate stop work.
Fair enough, thank you.
Mr. Pruitt, the first time you were on that site, was that on the 11th?
Yes, sir.
And then were you there again on the 12th?
Yes, sir.
Then subsequently on the 18th, is that correct? Is my timeline correct?
Yes, the 11th, 12th, and 18th.
And then 28th again?
Yeah, 12th, 28th.
So on the 11th and 12th, did you notice a stockpile of dirt?
No, sir.
Okay. When was the first time you noticed a stockpile of dirt?
12th, 28th.
So what was the original reason for coming out on the 11th?
Well, my supervisor called me and told me to meet him out at 3450 Bentwood Drive.
For what reason?
Somebody had called in a complaint about some work being done with...
Is more specific than just some work?
Yeah, he just phoned me and said, I need you to meet me out at this site. That they got a complaint about work being done, and the everybody complained about they needed permits.
And what work did you find he done there?
Well, what we came up with is it looked like that he was placing his utilities, whether it was maintenance or whatever, that he had placed his utilities.
Which is fairly commonplace.
Yes, and like I say, you have the right. You don't have to have a land disturbance permit to go in and maintain and place your utility.
On the 11th, you had no concern?
Right.
Okay, on the 12th, then you came back. Were you asked to meet someone on site again on the 12th?
No, I was contacted by my supervisor again to go out there and take some more photos.
So on the 12th, you went back to take more photos?
Yes.
And did you find anything unusual on the 12th?
No, it was the same.
So it was the same thing?
Yes.
Okay, and then the 18th?
The same.
More photos?
Yeah, I didn't know. I didn't actually go out on the 18th. I think that's when the rollback of the truck. They said there's a rollback out there. I went, the gates.
And that was Mr. Off. Briggs, right?
Huh?
That was Mr. Briggs calling you?
Yes. And I went out there and the rollback was already gone, and I just turned around and went about my business.
Previous to the 11th, had you ever been to that property?
No.
So that was the first time you did that?
Yes.
Thank you.
I said a couple of follow-up questions. Mr. Ford, any time you've been out there with respect to those dirt piles, have you ever seen BMPs in place?
No, sir.
And did the stop work order prevent Mr. Bose and Mommies properties from putting BMPs in place?
No, sir. Under a stop work, you are allowed to install your BMPs. That's the only land disturbance that you can do.
Did that ever take place between December 28th and February 15th?
There's none up to date.
That's all I have.
One more question. Have you ever been called to another horse farm previously for our land disturbance issues?
No, sir.
Okay.
Real quick, two more questions. Who's your supervisor? What's his
name? Kevin Nicks.
Do you know who contacted him?
I have no idea. He just called and told me to meet him on that side.
Nobody else badly contacted you except Kevin?
No, just Kevin Nicks, my supervisor.
Okay, thank you.
I have a follow-up question. Ordinarily, if you got a call or your supervisor got a call from an interested citizen, somebody would go out and check on it, regardless of who that citizen was.
Yes, sir. We respond to all complaints.
Thank you.
Do you have a question about any board members? Thank you, Mr. Pruitt. May I have a seat? Mr. Frickey, any of the other witnesses?
Mr. Neville, the candidate for president's
thanks.
Yeah, if there's any subsequent.
At this time, under the rules, anyone desiring to speak in favor of or in opposition to the application will be permitted to do so. So, anybody in support?
I apologize for doing that. I just want to make sure that I did understand, and I believe that was the situation, but I just want to make double sure that the exhibits were tendered and admitted into evidence. And I don't need to do that at this point in time.
No.
Except for 15.
Similarly, Ms. Neville, I had given a package to Ms. Susan, and I want the whole thing in evidence. I did not know that you're supposed to do it this way, like a trial. I had no idea. I've always been submitting papers directly to them in building, suite 100 downstairs, and I gave her my stamp. But most of them are here too, but it is, I would like all of them to be.
Well, first of all, why don't you and Mr. Frickey discuss that right now while we give anybody else a chance to speak and see if y'all can come to an agreement on anything to be admitted? I haven't seen what you want to admit.
She hasn't.
I haven't either.
Yeah, I submitted it downstairs.
Well, I mean, I know, but
yeah,
you needed to submit it during this hearing. That's what this was for.
I've always done it. I have no idea. This is my first time here. So it's in the file.
Well, again, you need to take, do you have a copy of what you want to introduce?
I haven't seen anything, and there's been no testimony that would suggest that there's any basis for such evidence.
I'm at a loss. I certainly can't agree to anything sight unseen, that's for sure. And I'm hesitant to do anything without even having any evidence or testimony with respect to it.
Can't agree. Yes. I will go over with you all the exhibits that I have submitted already. The whole package, it's in the file. So, is the file not evidence is my question.
This hearing is the proceeding for you to introduce any document that you want to introduce. Just because you give something to the office downstairs, that's not introducing the document. It may not be admissible. It may have hearsay. It may have a reason not to admit it. So no, just giving something to Ms. Green is not admitting the document in evidence. So.
Okay, I would like it in the record, please.
I'm going to object without a basis for its admission.
I'll sustain the objection. All right, at this time, I'm going to ask any person in support of the application, in other words, anybody who is in support of the appeal by Mr. Bose, if they would like to come forward and speak. Conversely, is there anyone in support of the county's position, and therefore in opposition to the application? Does anyone wish to speak at this time? Hearing nothing from anyone, at this time, does anyone have any rebuttal? I think there's any rebuttal evidence based on any public comments. So at this time, we'll have both sides present their closing argument. So, Mr. Bose, you have the right to open and conclude. You have 5 minutes to make your presentation. You can open and conclude, or you can reserve your right to conclude.
I'll just reserve my right to conclude.
Okay, Mr. Briggs.
Yeah.
plan to take a lot of time, but is there a specific time I need to really, is it 5 minutes that you originally said?
Members of the board, I appreciate your patience and understanding, and yes, there's a lot of information that may or may not have been relevant to the issue. Particular point here is whether or not a stop work order was entitled to be in place. The defense is effectively that it is entitled to an exemption, and the county has presented evidence, testimony from its employees and officers that, or employees of the county that indicate that the property was not subject to either agricultural or the 1 acre exemption due to the state waters being on the property. In further support of that, the county points to the exemption language, which specifically says that, and it's important to look at that, those statutes. I've got it's 3433 in the Munich Code version. It's exemption from this article A addresses only the need for a land disturbance permit. That's key because one of the issues that you've heard is the stop work order was issued for the lack of BMDs. The silt fence was the specific BMD that you heard. You heard that that could be placed despite the stop work order, and it was never done. The BMDs have never been put in place with respect to this particular issue, and it did justify in and of itself the placement of a stop work order in this place. That alone should end this case. I ask you to bear in mind that it is the individual seeking the benefit of the exemption that it has the burden of establishing the right to the exemption. The county has clearly shown this is an equestrian facility, county's code, which as Mr. Pruitt correctly indicated, the county has the right to be more stringent with respect to its protections. What that says is the county can be more protective of its soil and water rights, environmental rights, by limiting the applicability of the exemption, the county is placing greater protection on its property. That is what the county is entitled to. That's what it has done with respect to including this particular reference to the horse boarding on the property not being entitled to the exemption. Those particular points get rid of this appeal there and there alone. As indicated, address both of the exemptions that have been brought to your attention. The red herring about a question about whether or not Mr. Bose may have been told about this, the county posted it on his property, indicated he knew it was on his property. That's all the county's obligated to do. The county certainly, and also testified that they did send him that property. He never, if you know, Mr. Bose never indicated he didn't receive the certified mail. Wasn't required in any case. Again, as I indicated, a red herring. Gentlemen, that is the county's case in a nutshell. This is clear, plain, simple. County was entitled to issue this stop work order because Mr. Bose failed to get a permit beforehand. Mr. Bose failed to install BMPs. Either one of those alone was entitlement to issue the stop work order. The stop work order with respect to the BMPs in and of itself would entitle the county to issue the stop work order and was not subject to the exemptions in any case. This appeal should be denied. Thank you very much.
Thank you for your time and patience through this. It's been a long fight with the county, and it's 6 months, coming on 6 months now. And it's a little scary to listen to what Mr. Paul just said. He basically said, no due process, no service. That's what he said. It doesn't matter what the law says. How did he say that? He's saying that, okay, there's a process to give notice. So if somebody goes on vacation and is gone for a month, and you slap a no, whatever stop work order on there, and they don't know, the owners don't know, where is the process? That's what he said. So this precedent itself is dangerous. Setting that aside, we have gone through this, your ordinance 73, you went round and round, and I sincerely urge you all to actually take the time to go through the documents, and if necessary, put this off for the next hearing. Just go through the documents. And I don't know how many of your attorneys here, there's a lot of legalese here. I'm not an attorney, but I read through it and understand half of it. But what little I do understand is that it's less than 1 acre. There are different laws on the books. Some say 50 feet, some say 200 feet. There's state water, no state water. No matter what, there is that exemption for less than 1 acre. And it is not specified like they keep saying. It's only single family residents. So I am at loss at how they interpret what they interpret. But state law has, at the end of the day, it's Georgia Constitution that we also are protected under. So the stop work order. Yeah. Now, Mr. John asked a question about why didn't you give a stop work for land disturbance. No matter what, you're digging this land disturbance. You heard from Mr. Pruitt. If you're digging, you're moving dirt, it's land disturbance. So why don't you stop it? There is no law that says that for utilities only you cannot. No, there's nothing like that. Nobody's presented any evidence about that. But
he's completely misstating the law.
I'm sorry.
It's one thing to argue, it's like to misstate the code completely.
Go ahead.
Thank you. So, so he could have cited me on December 11th, he did, 12th, he did. But the most important theme here is that all this came from what I say in the complaint. And that is, it came from their administration and somebody complained. Fair enough, I don't have a problem with people complaining and them coming and looking at it. But how is it that happened consistently, and how did this particular case happen? And why did they only single me out? So there are other issues at play, but this is where they were able to do stop work order and not let me correct it after that. And that's exactly what happened. And then I heard that it is lifted. Now, I didn't get any notice about that either. It was lifted. The stop work was lifted. I have no idea when that happened. I just heard about it recently.
Yeah, it's in the email. There's no evidence of that.
That's right. It's there in the file. That's what I'm saying. Please take the time and put this off to next time. And it's all in
there. Objection is sustained.
Yeah. I have no idea about this process. And I've been following a certain process in Forsyth County with all these appeals. And there is submit all paperwork downstairs. And that's what I did. So I sincerely hope and that you all take the time to look at it and then get the full picture before you go. Thank you so much.
All right. Mr. Chairman, that concludes the hearing. I'll turn it back over to the board. The board, I think, under the rules, is entitled to ask any questions the doc desires to ask and then to make a decision.
And do we close the public hearing at this point in time and then ask our questions, or we'll leave it open and until we're done?
I would say go ahead and ask your questions and then you can move to close the public hearing.
Thank you. Questions, gentlemen?
I have a question. Where's the dirt?
I'm sorry?
Where's the dirt?
Oh, we took it out because he told us to dig out.
I understand the stop work order.
You know, there was so much conversation about the stop work order and what I can and cannot do. I didn't even know what this BMP thingy was, which I asked you to decipher for me right here in front of you. I've never heard of it before. So, no. And the dirt has been moved out of there because that's what they told me. I spoke to so many people in the county. And the goal was to make me apply. When you see the rest of the appeals, you'll understand why I was just languishing in there, just going through every step that you need to apply for a grading permit.
Okay, we'll speak about the rest of them.
Correct.
You moved
but
the dirt.
Related.
You moved the dirt after you received the stop work.
Because they told me.
Yeah, you answer my question.
Thank you, sir. They told me.
Yes.
And that cures the problem, right?
Actually, compounds it.
Yeah.
But are there other questions?
Mr. Bose, are you stating that there's evidence that you presented to staff which you have not been able to show here?
Yes, sir. That's exactly what I'm saying. Because I did not know your process.
But I think you should have educated yourself on the process, right? There's a big hearing. Everybody here is coming You should have been prepared.
Yes, they've been telling me every step of the way what to do next. The blind department downstairs is awesome. And they're always telling exactly what the next step is. So I keep following the steps. But I did not know that I'm supposed to, and this poor Ms. Green, actually, I gave her this whole file. She said she's going to make a copy to bring it here, but there's no time to do it. And I'm coming from Atlanta, and I did not have five copies to bring. I don't even have that set with me, which I thought would be presented here.
So you're claiming ignorance of the process, and I understand that. We're not lawyers. I'm not a lawyer.
No.
But you had a lawyer, and he didn't educate you on the process either. At least on AP1803, you have Stuart T. Esquire listed. Isn't he a lawyer?
Well, yes.
And he didn't tell you what was going to happen? You need
to about what?
About the hearing. This amazing what the hearing.
Oh, no. Yes. So I'm representing myself. So that happened several months back. And so I'm on my own, and you got to. I never went to the stage where he was going to present anything here. So that didn't happen.
But he also didn't tell you what you were facing. I think the problem is between you and him as far as not knowing what to do and not knowing what this was going to be. These hearings have happened before.
So my question to
come. I would like to say this. Even Mr. Paul didn't know what was going to happen today. He thought he was going first, and all this process is new. We just spoke outside. So you can't blame Mr. Teague or me for ignorance of the process. Mr. Paul is ignorant of the process.
But basically, okay. the only thing that's changed about the process, and Mr. Frickey is aware of what's happening, is we automatically move everything to the end of the meeting so that the people seeking a variance don't have to wait through all of this. And it's the order of how the things were presented and their time frames. But what happens during the hearing, as far as evidence presented, so on and so forth, that hasn't changed.
There's just been administrative changes, not process changes.
Yeah. I'm also familiar with the court, where you go and deposit everything at the clerk of the court. That's where you file it.
Sir.
So I'm not sure which way to go with
direct.
This. I'm sorry?
I hate to be direct.
Yes, sir.
But you should have a lawyer here, because your lack of knowledge of the process is not an excuse for not knowing the process. And I don't know what else to say.
Fair enough. The weeds here.
So thank you. We need to move forward.
We actually do.
Thank you.
So my question is, should he be given the opportunity to present his information to us?
He brought this at 5:00 and gave it to Ms. Green, so she didn't have an opportunity to copy it. I don't even haven't even looked over this, but it's a matter of whether Mr. Frickey would have any objections, whether it's hearsay, whether it's admissible.
My objection stood in the sense of I hadn't seen it, and there's been no testimony that would suggest that the documents were. It wasn't even referred to in the testimony, so that's part of the process of getting a document into evidence.
Other issues?
I have one other question. Mr. Pruitt, when you were testifying, you quoted the state law and saying that if the, the 200 feet from the dirt to the state waters doesn't matter if the state water is on the property, right?
Yes.
It doesn't have to be within 200 feet. Yeah, if it's on the property, he's got to take the beginning.
Yes, the state water is on the project site.
And I just wanted to make sure I understood.
I think we're done with the question. So, therefore, I will close, make a motion to close the public hearing for, I lost track of the number, AP180003. Do I hear a second?
Second.
Got a second? All those in favor? Okay. Discussion members. Is there any? We've heard a lot.
The question that I ask, is somewhat hypothetical in the standpoint that if his appeal is denied, can we attach a condition that he has and must complete covering up the utilities in 38?
You are allowed to approve the county's position, to disapprove the county's position, or amend. But I don't think covering up these utilities.
My understanding is that it's exactly that's allowed.
Yeah, but
he's just not taking any action to do it.
No, because my understanding was that it was because of the stop work order.
Stop work does not count. According to what Mr. Brunt said directly, utilities are allowed to install and cover up their equipment without permit.
The stop work order covered the trench as well.
The stop work order covered the trench as well.
Yeah.
That's what I understood.
That's what I understood. I understood it just the opposite, that it was allowed.
I think you can ask a question if you got clarification.
I want to know, does the county allow utility companies to install or cover up?
Can they complete that work with the work or the stop work order in place?
Yes, the utility companies can.
That's all I mean.
But doesn't he have some utilities that he has to cover up also?
Yes, and that was one of the things I was trying to make a point of, that from the date that we were out there, the first original date, I think it was the 11th, then to the 12th, or the 28th when I had issued the stop work, there had nothing been done with the utilities. And I work for utility companies. We wouldn't leave the site until those utilities were covered back up. We just wouldn't do that because of safety issue. And that's what he had from 11, even a couple of weeks after the stop work was issued, before I had the conversation with him, and I told him at that point that he did not need to do anything else or anything until we found out what was going on, until the county found out what was going on.
We heard language saying that these are utilities and that the utility company told him he had to do it, but we haven't heard any testimony or evidence that the utility companies or the cable company or whomever has told him. I mean, one time he referenced AT&T, another time it was Comcast, and then it was Sony Cable, I think it was. So I'm not convinced that we need to take that action at this point.
The utilities aren't the issue.
Right.
No,
the issue.
I understand that. But the utilities are a hazard, and I just want to give him if he's not allowed to work on it, I want to give him an opportunity to clean the utilities up. But if he hasn't had the time, to clean them up and he hasn't, then the hazard's his to deal with.
Are the utilities buried?
Have they filled in the trench?
Most of them are. There's the two sections there. Now, can I make a normal point? The dirt that was missing, if you were going to violate the stop work and the issue was getting your utilities covered up, why not take that four loads of dirt up there and finish burying all the utilities?
Breaking the stop work.
Well, he already broke it anyway. Is that all?
That's it.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.
Are we ready to make a motion? Gentlemen, anything else? I will make a motion.
My district.
Oh, I'm sorry, no.
But I mean, that's your prerogative, Mr. Chair.
Well, if I don't disagree with it, I'll tell you.
All right. Mr. Chairman, I move that the board affirms the county's decision for appeal application AP number 180003.
I have a motion. Do I hear a second?
I second.
I have a motion and a second. Any more discussion?
Yeah. Here? Just want to say, we have a very clear and narrow definition within which we should rule.
Yes, we do. ZBA shall only reverse or modify.
I don't know what the history behind this is, but the 11th, 12th, 18th, 28th seems a bit much.
But is it relevant to the decision that we're
making? But I'm allowed to state my opinion.
Exactly.
Yep. It's not the rule, but it's an opinion.
Okay. All right, we have a motion, we have a second. All those in favor of affirming the motion to affirm the county's decision in regard to AB 180003, please raise your right hand. It's unanimous. And we need another break. Maybe 10 minutes?
Well, yeah.
Before you get a sense of the intention of their own vote, I do have witnesses and don't know what the intention of the board are. We're going forward with all five or not.
Well, we have a question. This last proceeding took, 2 hours? Just about? And I have had board members ask that we postpone. I would hesitate to do that because we're going to encounter similar time frames at the next meeting. I would propose that if we postpone, we go through one more, which would be seven, and postpone the other three until next month. If that could be agreeable to everybody, if it's not, we'll stay here and do it.
I will say on the hands back, I have no objection to that. Maybe I should consult with the witnesses who have sat through. But I will say, I believe we can promptly resolve the 06, the appeal that ends in 06. I don't think we should include that in any of the considerations, because by promptly, I don't believe there's need to be any consideration. Or
so would you rather have do 7 and 6, or
if you would just give me
one. Sure. So take a 10-minute break, probably you
work. May I ask a question, sir?
Sure.
Okay. So this actually covers the bulk of pretty much all of them. So in terms of where it's going, only if he has witnesses it'll be longer. If there are no witnesses, it'll be very short. And I don't have any more to say unless there are witnesses that come out of it.
Well, yes. We're just going to have to see how it goes.
Yes, I'd rather we finish it. And when is the next meeting?
1 month. It'll be, what's the day?
July.
July.
No, we can't.
Could
it be on the agenda? August 7th or September 4th?
August, okay. It would have to be August 7th or September 4th.
August 7th or September 4th?
Yes.
We can go fast. Y'all have had a work session, so all of you are aware of pretty much all the issues, so we can really move fast on this. That's where I'm. I'd rather we finish everything
together.
Whether we have any more here, if the next one takes long, then we can defer.
That's true. The only reason I ask is I have witnesses that would be for the later one, not the earlier one. If we were knowing that we were not going to go, I wouldn't ask them to stick around to wait and see. But I have no objection to postponing. I would suggest that 07 go, 06 can be handled, 04 and 05 are related individuals.
We actually had these separate. We put them together for this reason, so they'll all be together. So I really prefer we take for it to be together. We'll really go fast. I'm serious. I'd really rather finish everything in one shot. It depends on your witnesses.
I just say.
If there are witnesses, I'll go after that.
Depends on how many questions those witnesses.
Yeah, I will. If you put witnesses up, I will question. I don't know any of these people. Thank you.